Every summer in Australia, we always talk about sharks.
There are fears a monster shark, measuring more than 5 metres, is lurking off North Stradbroke Island in Queensland.
A massive great white shark, up to 4.5 metres long.
I am never going back in the water.
Me either.
Well, we talk about fearing sharks. In 2016, there were only 2 fatal shark attacks in Australia. In 2015, there were also 2, and one was provoked. Sharks are a pretty common fear, but they attack us incredibly rarely, and mostly by accident. Turns out, humans are pretty bad at understanding and managing risk. Some things sound scarier than they really are, while others are just too mundane to worry about. But the truth is, almost everything in the world is trying to kill you. Sorry, but life is hard. And we hear about the rare and scary things more than we hear about the mundane things, building our irrational fear and minimizing our awareness of common risks. And it's important to know how to protect ourselves from the common and the uncommon stuff. Spiders are a great example. Over 30% of people are self-described arachnophobes. Australia's funnel web spider is considered the deadliest spider in the world. But there have been no confirmed deaths from funnel web bites since the anti-venom was invented in 1980. Even the brown recluse spider in the US, another highly venomous arachnid, has only caused 3 recorded deaths, ever. As scary as they seem, spiders are very unlikely to kill you. Even bigger and louder things like lightning strikes cause fewer than 30 deaths in the US each year. The real killers of the world are much more mundane. Take transportation. On average, about 500 people die in plane crashes worldwide each year, and that's one of the safest ways to travel. Around the world, there's about 1.25 million traffic fatalities each year. Driving a car or motorcycle, biking and walking are all way more likely to kill you than flying, especially when you're not wearing a seatbelt or you're distracted while on the road. And cancer is even more likely to kill you than your commute. Each year, more than 8 million people die from cancer. The cancer could be from smoking, pollution, alcohol consumption, diet, poor health, or just bad luck. What's worse, cancer rates are expected to increase by about 70% over the next 20 years, mostly due to people living longer and long enough to get it. This makes preventing cancer tough. Even if you eat healthy, don't smoke, and exercise regularly, you can still get cancer. There's ways to reduce your risk, but no scientifically backed ways to prevent it. If there was, wouldn't you jump at the chance? Over the past few hundred years, scientists have worked diligently to cure, prevent, and treat deadly diseases. And one of the best tools is the vaccine. We have vaccines for dozens of deadly diseases, including some types of cancer. And yet, over 3 million people worldwide still die every year from vaccine-preventable diseases. About half of those deaths are children under 5 years old. There's lots of things out there trying to harm you, your family, your friends, and your neighbours. But if you get vaccinated and vaccinate your kids, there's one less big bad for you to worry about. And maybe don't provoke a shark while you're swimming in a lightning storm.